subscribe and hit the bell icon to never miss another update from India Forums.
Well, hi guys, welcome back again to India Forums. We are going to be having a fun live chat session with Namik Paul. You guys highly requested for us to get him, and finally we are having him on the live. I'm quickly going to add him and then we can start chatting with him. Hi Namik, welcome.
Hi, how's it going? Thank you so much.
Okay, first up, we want to know, and everybody wants to know, what has quarantine been looking like for you and what is your routine?
Quarantine's been okay because I've been home. I came home just to visit my parents because it had been a very long time. And then we had that Sunday, which was like the practice run. And I was supposed to come back to Bombay for an audition. So I was like all set. But then there was some like news that might get extended or something. So that got cancelled. And thankfully it got cancelled because then I ended up staying back here. And it's good. Yeah, I'm with my family. I'm at home with my dog. It could be a lot worse, honestly.
Right. Ajay, since you're at home, have you also been one of those jo sare household chores kar rahe hain? Like now they're doing it because abhi quarantine mein you have to do all your work on your own.
I had to do some of my work back home in, back in Bombay also.
Right.
Because my maid was very apni marzi ke malik. She would come whenever she wanted and she wouldn't come when she wanted. So I would end up washing my dishes and cleaning the rooms and stuff quite a lot. But she had been with me for a while, so it's okay. But yeah, it's okay. I mean, it's okay. This is just normal things you have to do.
Right.
Mostly you have to take care of Hobbs, which is my dog. And that I love doing, so I'm good.
Acha, there is Drishti Patil 24 asking, what is written on Namik's shoulder tattoo?
Hi Drishti Patil. What's written on my shoulder tattoo is something that was, it seemed like a very good idea to me when I was in school. It doesn't seem like a very good idea to me right now. But thankfully it's in Japanese, so it's good. So I'd rather keep it a secret.
Kashvi Mehrotra is asking, Namik, you have gotten Shravan Malhotra wala haircut and the same beard. This is so nostalgic. Have you
I haven't gotten anything actually. It is growing out, whatever is happening. And the beard, I had to, I'm doing something else. So it's just small right now because it was getting too big for me to handle. But it's not by design. Whatever it is, it's just growing out. I haven't got a haircut in 2.5 months. And that is okay. It's not a big deal. But it's not a planned look or anything.
Okay. There is Mridu_26. Her first question is, did you revisit your childhood through photos this quarantine?
Mridu, my parents, especially my mom, keep sending me pictures when I'm in Bombay, whenever she cleans the house and she finds old pictures. So that's more of a reliving it. It's not like I'm not home. I mean, this time it was a very long break coming back.
Right.
But usually I used to come back quite a lot to Dehradun. So it's not a very nostalgic thing. I'm much more excited to be home right now with my parents, actually.
Her next question is, what would be a good theme song that describes your life?
It's still the same from 2016, Safarnama, I guess. I can't think of anything. This is a very weird question to answer, but yeah, let's go with that.
Okay, and her third question is, what ridiculous thing has someone tricked you into believing, into doing or believing?
Sometimes directors will have fun with you. We'll be in the middle of a scene, so we'll be like into it. And then they'll be like, and like I'm crawling under the camera and stuff, trying to get somewhere. And then I realize that it's just a trick, and everybody's laughing at you because you think like the director wants you to do it. So like, oh, okay, I didn't know I would have to do this. But that's the only thing I can think of.
Do you remember like which show was it the last time?
Ek Diwana Tha, Ek Diwana Tha comes music, because I was a ghost, so I couldn't talk.
And,
yeah, so sometimes they would set up the camera like, you know, I would have to be here, like I'm a ghost and suddenly I'm somewhere else. So I thought it was normal. So he's like it was crawling. I literally crawled on the ground under the camera so I would get caught and stood on the other hand and everybody's laughing. So yeah, that pretty much sticks out.
Okay, there is a question from Varma Vitika. She's asking, cooking में क्या सीखा एंड when are you posting videos of you cooking?
Hi Vitika, I haven't learned anything new since the last time I had a chat. It's just the same thing, pancakes and chicken and rice. Rice, I don't think you have to cook, you just have to boil it. So yeah, that's the level of my cooking. That's why you're not getting any pictures, but I'll see. Maybe I'll make some pancakes and post a picture.
All right. There is a question from I am Samira. She's asking, what's Namik's dreams?
Hi Samira, my dreams are one to do well in life, hopefully do well in my career because that's very important to me, and just make my family proud, I guess, and take care of everybody that I love.
There
Not
is
very,
more.
not yeah.
There is Moksha asking which was your favorite show?
Out of what I've done?
I am not sure. She's not specified, but we can go with both, like one which you've done and one which you like to watch.
Like to watch. Okay, Moksha. Hi, Moksha. My favorite show, Ek Dooje Ke Waaste, is definitely special because it was my first break. But they're all quite special in their own way. You get to learn a lot from whatever I've done. Each show has a very vivid set of memories associated to it, so I can't really pick one. What I'm watching right now, I really like this show, which is by HBO, I think, on Hotstar called What We Do in the Shadows. It's a comedy.
Okay. There is Cherry underscore Modi asking, how do you manage talking to all your friends? Like,
It's very easy
have you
right
been
now.
like catching up?
Hi Cherry, it's very easy right now because everybody's sitting at home free, so it's not like anybody can say, like I'm busy with something. And there's not a lot to talk about, unfortunately. There was in the beginning. Now it's just like we know what we're doing all day. But you still kind of chat online, mostly messaging, calling not as much, and maybe some video calling once in a while, get on a group and talk to everybody.
Right.
Yeah, well, it's very easy right now.
Okay. There was somebody on the story who asked you that is your favorite Indian like dish a butter chicken or tandoori chicken like
तंदूरी
in
चिकन
दोनों में से अच्छा so they were confused कि इन दोनों में से something you've said but they cannot remember which is why they wanted you to
नो इट्स तंदूरी
specify.
चिकन आई हैड इट प्रीटी मच ट्वाइस अ डे फॉर द लास्ट 7 8 years सो इट्स डेफिनेटली दैट
Right. Okay. The next question is from Nandita, and she's asking, are you enjoying quarantine with family? It's a very obvious question, so I'll
yeah
just modify it a little bit. Tell me, when was the last time your family had you around for such a long period of time?
Okay, hi Nandita. I don't think it's this long has been at least 4 5 6 years since I've been at home for this long. I
Right.
think they might be regretting me having me around for so much time now. I think they're kind of sick of, over it by now. Yeah, I'm loving it because this was kind of the plan. Like once Kasauti ended, I did want to take a break and come home for a while. I
Huh.
didn't think it would be this long because usually you get auditions and you have to go back to Bombay, have meetings. But no, nothing is happening, so it's a very guilt-free and stress-free because I'm not thinking like, should I be there? Should I be auditioning? Should I be talking to people? So I'm
Right.
just chilling. It's fun.
There's no FOMO because like you're not missing
Not
out
at
on
all.
anything.
Not at all. No FOMO.
Okay. There is Rehana dot Shakir asking, how is your bonding with Nikita? A lot of people are asking ki, have you guys been in touch? Do you talk and all of that? So if you can address all of them once
Okay, hi Rihanna and the untold masses who have asked this question.
it
It is absolutely fine. The last time I met her was when we posted the picture. It had been 4 years, but it was actually the anniversary. It was February 29th and the leap year thing. And we
Right.
met and we hung out, and it's absolutely fine. It's the, you get very close to people and you're very good friends with them when you're shooting. And then we move on to different projects, and then we're surrounded by different
Right.
people. So it's not like you talk every day, but whenever I meet anybody, and it's not just Nikita, it's Vikram, Donald, Deepika, anybody I meet, it's always a good time catching up. We have a lot to talk about, and it's very pleasant and warm when I meet them, which is what's important.
There is insanity underscore cool 89 asking, how were your shooting days of ek dooje ke waste?
Hi, insanity underscore something something 89. It was great, yaar. It was the first time that I got to learn so many things. I think I was very stressed out. I've since learned to relax a bit when I'm shooting. On that show, I was always very like, I have to perform and all of these things, which you can do without being so stressed up and pent up. But I got to learn everything. It was my start. I got so much love for that character. I still get so much love for that character, for that show. I'll always be very grateful for it. And it's a very special show for me. And I'll always say that.
Right. You know, when you initially like auditioned for the character and whatever, like Shravan ke liye, did you ever like anticipate ki he's going to go out and become such a rage? And it's not only like a show, like as you also mentioned, ki even today people like associate you with Shravan. And did you ever think, even while shooting?
The first audition, I almost walked out before doing the audition because the guy who was taking the audition, I remember there were four or five of us waiting and there was somebody who did the audition and it was okay, you're in line. And my turn comes and the guy who was taking the audition suddenly takes a lady in. That, ma'am, ko kahin jana hai, aap inhe karne dijiye na.
Achha.
So it's ma'am, so you're like, okay, theek hai, ma'am, kar lijiye aap. So they do it. But I'm not happy because you're also very stressed out. Haan. Like, it's a very long, and I had to be like very, like I was screaming, ki main tumhara kitchen band kara dunga and all of this. So I was already in that mode. I'm like, okay, she gives the audition, she's leaving, and then this other guy comes, and he's like, nahi, aap rukiye, main inka le leta hoon pehle. I'm like, I've been waiting, and it's my turn. He's like, nahi, ye aise 2 minute mein ho jayega, sir. So I'm like, mera le lo 2 minute mein. And I started getting like, because you was being very condescending. He's like, nahi, aap, kya, aap thoda wait nahi kar sakte. So I'm like, okay, listen, I'm going, and I don't want to audition. And Richa, who had called me for the audition, was right there. So she stopped me and she's like, "Arey, ruko, 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 tum idhar aao." And she took me to the conference room. She called for thanda water and she's like, "Listen, calm down, pani piyo, relax. Aisa hota hai, wo pagal hai. Tum bas apni line hi socho. Your look fits. So this can work. This can work." So she calmed me down and then she took my audition. So that audition almost didn't happen. So I never imagined that I would go this far. But that's true for everything. I don't think I ever imagined this career. You hope for it, but you can never imagine really.
Right, but you would have sort of do you think you would have regretted a little?
No, I had been rejected. I had been turned down from so many auditions, and not rejected. The worst part is if they tell you that, listen, this is why you don't fit the part. You good because you're like, okay, maybe my look doesn't matter. Happen, or if they tell you your acting isn't good, then you can work on your acting. But everybody would just say, "Aapne bahut achha kiya," and they would say that. That's not usually what you hear. But I would never hear back. So I was done. Like, I was like, main ye shared show ke jaane wala, this is not working out. This acting thing is not happening. Like, that is why I was ready to walk out. Because I was like, na lo audition, but aise, matlab line hai, to line mein lo. Because that's how professionalism is done. Like, that's how auditions were done. So I had no idea I would get it. But I was like, ye nahi main sahan karunga yahan pe.
Okay, there is Kashvi also asking you that do you watch Ek Dooje Ke Waste? Like now?
No, not really. I don't watch any of my shows that much. Once in a while, one episode will pop up on YouTube or something, just by suggestions. And if it's something that like sparks a memory, because for me, like it's not the episode, but it's like what I remember about the shooting. Then I might just check it out to see how I did it, but it's kind of embarrassing looking at, because you're always like, yaar, I could have done this better, like I could have been like this here, should have done that there. But in its own way, it's very fond memories for me whenever I do happen to see some little bit, but not really sit down and watch it.
Correct. Okay, there is a question from Lavanya and
how did this suddenly pop up?
If you select, it comes.
Oh, so. Okay. I've never done this before. Okay. Hi, Lavanya and Adar. What's the best lesson you've learned from Ek Dooje Ke Waste? So many. It's literally everything I learned about being in front of the camera was on that show. So I can't really pick one. I guess working with, like, learning from other people, being willing to learn from as many people as you can and not being close to that. It doesn't matter the age, the experience, it's you can learn something from everybody. I think that's what I've taken away from it.
Right. There is a question from Tanya, and she's asking, what's your beautiful memory of Ek Diwana Tha sets?
Hi, Tanya. Ek Diwana Tha was completely different from Ek Dooje Ke Waaste. It was like a completely different experience. And with hanging out with Vikram, hanging out with Donald, because all three of us, like they would be doing their scene, I would suddenly pop up from behind. So we were always together. And I think the lenses and stuff would be one thing that I'm kind of like, I'm never doing that again. But besides that, hanging out with those three people, hanging out with Prateek, the whole unit was super nice. Going to, we shot in Manali in the snow.
Right.
And I was literally wearing something like this thin, with just a thermal inside. And like chattering, like I couldn't speak because my teeth were chattering because I was so cold. So all of those things are like memories, which at that time I was like, oh my God, I'm dying of the cold. But now it's like, right, that was something memorable that we did.
Tanya's also asking you your all-time favorite song.
All-time, there's too many. It always keeps changing. I can't pick one favorite song. I can't pick one favorite song. There's so many good songs. It's like picking another, your favorite movie. There are so many good movies.
Another most asked fan question is, have you been watching or have you even a little bit of watched Ek Dooje Ke Waaste season 2? Like here and there on Instagram or something?
No, I don't watch any. I don't watch my shows, so why, there's no chance that I would watch other shows. And I'm not saying it to, like, to be derogatory. I'm not watching anything in this quarantine. But I have nothing to do with the show. I keep getting questions about it. It's a completely different show. I get the title is the same and some similarities are there. But besides that, I have nothing to do with it. So it doesn't really make sense asking me about it.
Right.
You know, again, like in, no, I'm not trying to put anything down. I would like to make that clear.
But you know, initially, like now, to it's sort of gone down a bit. But pehle, like initially, when the idea of the show coming back came, there were so many of your fans and Nikita's fans who, you know, started petitions ki nahi, bring those two only back together. We don't want to see new faces and all of that. Did you see any of those petitions, and what was your reaction?
That has been going on since the show shut down. I remember we went for the meeting for Ek Diwana Tha in Sony.
Right.
And Danish, who's the programming head, who's like the head of Sony. And we sit down and we say hello and everything. And then he looks at me and he's like, your fans. I'm like, what do you mean? He's like, they've been after my life. That's the first thing he said. So they had been emailing him and everything to continue the show, to restart the show. So they've always been very, very passionate. It's very sweet. And it's in a way, it's a good thing. I don't, it's a very sweet gesture is all I'll say.
Right. Shivani is asking, which is the latest book that you are reading?
I'm still trying to struggle through this Infinite Jest. I've been talking about it for 4 years. I've had it for 4 years, but I'm finally reading it. It's a 700 page book. I'm about 400 pages in. And now I've kind of hit the flow, like the pages are turning. In the beginning, it was very hard, but that's what I'm reading right now.
Right. There is Deepa writing, you were damn good in Ek Diwana Tha. Is there a season 2 coming?
Thank you, Deepa. I don't think so. I talked to Prateek once in a while. Prateek Sharma, who's just made Bear 2, and he was the producer of the show. No, there was no plan. I think that was the plan. It was actually a 6-month show. It got extended because Sony wanted us to extend. We did the whole rebirth thing that was not originally planned. It was just supposed to end with us dying and Vyom coming back as a ghost. But we got 2 extra months out of it. I'm very glad that you liked it so much. But I don't think there are any plans as such. Vikram is already doing another show. And Donald might be doing something else. So I don't think there's a chance.
Okay, Talkative Angel is writing, how are you maintaining fitness in lockdown days?
Hi, Talkative Angel. It's again, I would say it's kind of easy because literally I have nothing to do when I wake up. So it's become part of my schedule to wake up and work out. And it makes me feel good, like I'm doing something, I'm at least achieving something. There's more space here. And I managed to, right when the lockdown was being announced, I ordered a kettlebell from Amazon. And they delivered it literally the day before everything got shut down, and I had one band that I got from Bombay, so it's worked out pretty well. And I'm doing what I can. It's not like going to a full gym, But seeing the situation, I would rather not go to gyms for a while right now.
Okay, there were also many questions that when are we going to see you in a web project? So is there something that's in the pipeline?
There is literally nothing in the pipeline. Like the audition that I mentioned to you that I was supposed to happen in Bombay, I was kind of sad that I didn't make it because it was a very good project. Just I think 1 or 2 weeks ago, I read that it has been scrapped, even though it was an amazing project. Yeah, I won't say what it was, but it was very, very good. And it's just been scrapped because now nobody knows when shooting will start, when people are going to be free, what the people who are already in the project, if they have dates. So everything is so up in the air right now, work-wise. It's very hard to say when or how things will happen. Obviously, once work starts, I'll try my best. And once it's happening, I'll let you know.
Right. But you would be like, of course, open to doing something on
the web. Absolutely. Absolutely. I've already done the trip. That was like 4 years ago. Three years ago.
Right.
Yeah, but I would love to do something again. It's so much fun. In 1 or 2 months, you're done shooting. And it's quick. It's like, yeah, great characters also.
Right. There is Kushi0224 asking, what's your fear or phobia?
Hi, Kushi. I have a phobia. I forget what the name is, of small holes like in things. If you remember, there was this thing on Facebook where somebody was posting that if you put deodorant or something, like something will grow on your back. It was disgusting. It literally gave me nightmares. And everybody was posting it. Two or three years ago, it was horrible, and I was like, what is wrong with me? Like, why am I reacting? Like, I would see it, and there would be like a reaction, like literal reaction, where I would feel like throwing up. And thankfully, I read an article that there is a name for it, and it's even a beehive, like small holes in situations kind of make me like it gives me a very weird feeling. I can't remember the name.
Okay. There is Apoorva writing, what if Shravan Malhotra met Angad Jindal?
I'm sure they'll get along. Angad Jindal was a very sweet guy. I have no idea. I mean, I never think about that. They both seem like great guys and they're very professional. So I don't know. I think they'd get along and say bye.
Okay, second question that she asked is... Second question that she's asking is, if you can go out on a date with a person dead or alive, who would it be?
Go on a date? What a weird question. I don't know. I would have to get to know at least something about the person on a personal level. If you're just talking about looks, I can name all the good-looking actresses. They're all very, very good-looking. But, that's not everything. And you do need kind of something to talk about. So it's a very hard thing to say. If you're just asking who I think is good looking.
But it's just a date. Like, you don't have to date that person. You just go and get to know them.
I hope you would have a conversation at least on the date. I would be interested.
Hema Vikram Gill is asking you, what is your favorite place? Which is your favorite place in Dehradun?
My home. You can ask my friends. I don't leave my house. The only reason I leave my house mostly is to go to the gym. Otherwise, I'm pretty much holed up here. I have Hobbs. I have my parents. I have my house. We have lots of space to walk around and stuff. I'm pretty happy here.
Okay, there was somebody. Yeah, there is Labdish asking you, do you plan to do a reality show?
Hi, Labdish. No, I don't think any of them really appeal to me. I don't know. Yeah, most 99% of them don't appeal to me. If I get approached for the 1%, maybe. But I would much rather, I like acting way more than presenting myself as Namik in front of the screen. So I would much rather do something work-wise.
There is Mridu_26 writing that phobia is called trypophobia.
Trypophobia, yeah.
Okay, there is Yogita Kinney writing, thoughts on directing a show?
Hi Yogita, I do not have the patience. I have learned, I've learned that I do not have the patience to direct. Directors have a very, very hard job. They have to manage so many things and they have to manage so many people with different temperaments. So I have a hard time managing myself sometimes. So there's no way I can take responsibility for other people. Maybe down the line. But right now, no chance.
Varun Jangiani is asking, Hi Namik, sir, are you single and ready to mingle?
Hi, Chunky. That's a friend of mine. And I'm good, man. I'm good. We'll talk on a private, privately.
Okay. There is Aarti writing, have you finally learned the difference between Gujarati and Bengali language?
So, in my last live, somebody asked me if I could speak Bengali, and I was like, Kem cho, maja ma. And I said very confidently also. And then later people were like, that's Gujarati. And I was like, my bad. Yeah, so I know Kem cho, maja ma is Gujarati. I still can't really speak Bengali. Balo Bashi. Okay. Is that a word? I hope it
is. Yeah, yeah. Bengali is... There is Brishti Saha writing, your favorite character till date.
Oh, and Sandeep Sikand is online. The guy who, he is the one who wrote and used the project in Kavach. And he also made Kaamt, Kaatum, which has a lot of fans. My favorite character, I love all of them. I honestly love all of them. None of them have I just gone in and said the lines. I've tried to put as much of myself and as much as I could into each one of them. So they're very, very, they're all very important to me. And they've got me, all of them got me love from different people. A lot of love from different people. So I love all of them. I honestly do.
Okay, there was somebody, I missed the name, but she was asking that how had your experience been with Kasauti?
Kasauti was fun. It was fun. Playing a villain, which I got to do in Kavach also, once in a while I would get possessed and I would go crazy. When you're playing a villain, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, Kavach was also one of my favorite. Abhinav was great, Sandeep. But playing a villain in short bursts is so much fun because you really get to go all out. Like, you can use your eyebrows and you can change your voice. And I wouldn't say overact, but you can go larger than life, especially when you're playing a villain. And it's fun. I had fun once, like, the thing was revealed, and I was only there for 2 or 3 months. And everybody was super sweet, so it was a short and very sweet experience.
But were you a little bit skeptical or anything before playing a negative character? Because, you know, like, ek hero ki image hero wali hoti hai, and then people associate you with that. So, did you ever give that a thought?
Bye, Sandeep. No, I played in, especially because in Ek Diwana and Kavach, I played not just a good guy, I played the archetypal good guy. I was like a version of Ram Bhagwan. Like, they were both so good that bad things did not even occur to them. Even though it would be as horrible to them, they'd still be good to you. That is a great concept, but after a while, once you play so good, like, you're such a nice guy that I maybe kind of swung the other way. Like, I was like, villain? Like, yeah, I'm in. Like, I want to do it. And I was waiting. Like, I was waiting for that big turn when he becomes a villain. And when it happened, I was very, very excited. So, I had a blast with it. And I knew it was a cameo. Like, it was not something I would keep on for a year, 2 years. I'm playing a villain. So, in that regard, it was literally, it took me 10, 15 minutes to think about it and just say yes and let's do it.
Right. You know, after doing shows, like full-fledged shows, actors can get thoda skeptical about doing a cameo also. Like, you know, a show is running, I don't want to, like, go in between or anything. So, has that occurred to you ever?
It doesn't occur to you. Other people make it occur to you. Like, they'll be like, tu cameo kar raha hai? Like, soch, image ke baare mein soch. All of that. But they say that about everything. They say that
also told that before, like, you did Kasauti? Why are you doing it?
Yeah, get that about from everything. Like, cameo, are you sure you want to do this? But then people say, like, why are you doing TV? People will say anything. Everybody has an opinion, and there will always be somebody who will give you some negative feedback on some... which will put that in your mind, like, should I do this or not? I've stopped kind of listening to that. If it appeals to me, if it's exciting, I go for it. And I had a blast on Kasauti. I have no regrets. And honestly, with what has happened, I'm glad I did it because you also have to think work is work. And
true.
We have ghar bhi chalana hota hai. And with what has happened, it's been right. a great. Imagine if I hadn't done that, I would have been out of work for like almost a year now.
Right. Because of that.
So, yeah, we are working actors. The working part is also important. So that is also another aspect of it. But besides that, you can't think of what everybody is going to say. You just kind of have to do the
things. True. Okay, there is Sanyogita Chalwade writing. How long did you take to set up your hair before this live session?
It literally took me 5 minutes. I don't know if that's long for other people, but it did not take me very long. It's grown out. There's nothing to style. I've just put it and it is what it
but
is.
But there are so many people, like even on the Q&A that I put out, people were like, yeah, ask him about the secret behind his hair and his beard. Have you also been getting that question a lot?
The secret behind my beard, my hair, is that it grows out of my face. And especially the beard.
Like all you maintain
I just put a trimmer and the hair has not been cut. I would say my hairstylist, Rishika at Mad Award in Bombay, is amazing because it still looks kind of okay. It hasn't become like a whole jungle. But besides that, I take no credit. It is what it is right now.
Okay, and the last question that we'll take.
One of my friends came online and I think I missed it. It's her birthday today. Happy birthday, Smriti. Many happy returns of the day. She just sent me a message ki, like, you're not my friend. So, very happy birthday. I wish you the best for this year ahead and lots of love.
Cover up.
Yeah.
Okay, and the last question that we'll take is from Tanya, and she has written, any movie offers because you can give a tough competition.
Oh, Tanya, that's so sweet of you to say. I did audition for a couple of movies and obviously they didn't work out. But things are happening. Let's see whatever happens after this lockdown. I'm going to keep trying. And what if it works out, that'd be great. And anything good, any good work is always welcome. So it's not like I'm sitting and saying no to movie offers. That has not happened. Like somebody sent it to me, I'm like, nahi, mujhe nahi karni. That has not happened yet. But let's see what happens after the lockdown. Let's hope for the best.
Right. And if I were to ask you that if you could do one thing when the lockdown gets over, like the very first thing, what will that be?
I would love to work. Just go back to work. It's been like, I said,
there's nothing that you've been like craving to eat or go out, visit, travel, nothing.
Travel was the plan, but 8 years of traveling gaya. Like nobody's gonna, you're not going to want to travel, unfortunately, because that is why I said I had planned to take a break from work for 5-6 months, travel a little bit, kind of rejuvenate and go back to work hopefully. But मैंने ये नहीं सोचा था कि ये जबरदस्ती का ब्रेक हो जाएगा मेरा वी ऑल स्टक एट होम राइट नाउ सो ट्रैवलिंग इज आउट ऑफ द विंडो अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स आर आउट ऑफ द विंडो बिकॉज़ ऑफ इवन व्हेन वी गेट आउट ऑफ द लॉकडाउन वी विल हैव टू सोशली डिस्टेंस वी विल हैव टू वेयर अ मास्क वी विल हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट वी आर स्टेइंग एज सेफ एज वी कैन सो अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स हैव गॉन आउट ऑफ द विंडो दैट मे बी गोइंग टू अ मूवी वुड हैव बीन नाइस गोइंग टू द जिम वुड हैव बीन ग्रेट ऑल ऑफ दैट इज गॉन फॉर मी बिकॉज़ इट्स जस्ट नॉट safe right now.
It's not so
hopefully calm aa jaye something good and get back to it.
Okay, there is Sakshi who is there on the live since the very beginning and she's asking you favorite dessert. Please mera bhi question pooch lo. So what's your favorite dessert?
Oh sweet. Hi Sakshi, my favorite dessert right now is this dark chocolate that I'm eating. I just called for 2 or 3 bars of it and just having 1 or 2 pieces every day because I am trying to eat thoda sa clean. But that is what I'm eating right now. I had halwa 2 or 3 days ago. That was very, very good. And I had 2 or 3 bowls, so that wasn't cool. And I was like, ab mat banana, please. Ya mujhe offer mat karna agar bane to. But yeah, those would be 2 or 3 things that I've eaten recently.
Right. Thank you so much, Namik, that you took out time and you joined us. Your fans also told us that please tell him to become more active on Instagram, post more pictures.
I will.
So you should consider that during this lockdown.
I will. Thank you so much for the live India Forums and thank you for all your questions. Thank you for hosting this. I would just like to say, please, 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 I know we are moving towards reopening and getting back to it. But please keep there. It's very simple, guys. Maintain 6 to 10 feet distance. Please wear a mask. We are in the orange zone. I go out and I see a lot of people just walking around without masks. It's not very hard. Just put on a mask if you're going out. And yeah, obviously clean your, wash your hands and stay safe, all of you. And lots of love.
You also stay safe and take Thank care you. Until we see you next time whenever next we time. See you.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye. Bye. So guys, that was Namik Paul for y'all. And okay, there are a few people writing that I couldn't take your question. I'm very sorry if I couldn't take your question. Maybe next time. And yes, thank you so much for sending in your questions and making this live fun, interesting, informative, entertaining, everything. Yes, Samira, I'm going to save the live. And everybody, in case you've missed out on any part of the live, I am going to save it so you can catch it up. It's also going to be there on YouTube. So you can go watch it there as well. The handle on YouTube is India Forums. So yes, I'm going to save the live hansika.ar. And yes, next time soon, probably Shalu. And yes, that's about it. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining in. And yes, until tomorrow, when we come back with Aditya Kumar, aka Addy. Stay home, stay safe, take care. And that's about it. Goodbye.
Hey guys, check out our revamped website at www.indiaforums.com to get your daily dose of entertainment.